Hey everyone, and thanks for joining me. I just wanted to do a quick video on, as you can see here, a Jane Davenport delivery that arrived today. So let's take a look, and I might even do a few swatches and kind of like a mini review and see how all of it fares. Okay, so that was kind of a struggle to open, and it shouldn't have been. Alright, I just wanted to quickly say as well, I apologize if you can hear the baby monitor in the background. That's the lowest volume I can set it at. It obviously it has to play sound in case, you know, I need to be alerted to my baby, so apologies if you can hear that. I really like the personalized little message, and I promise I will have fun with these. Oh, that is so cute! I didn't order these. Oh, okay, cool. So they're little magnets. Each magnet can hold 12 sheets of A4 paper, and there's 5 ladybird magnets, and I love the little bag that it came in too. Oh, I love it, that is so cute. Oh, very thoughtful, thank you. This is 5 sheets of washi tape. I've been wanting this for ages just because it's so bright and so vibrant. Oh, I love it. So they're different widths as well. So this one's quite narrow, but this one's wide. Oh, beautiful colors. This is a really quick way to sort of snazz up some of your pages or even your planner, if that's what you like to do. Okay, so this is the gesso and the matte medium. I love the artwork on the packages because I cut them all up and I hoard the images. Let me show you. This is one of my journals for this year. It's like a daily journal. I cut out and kept, this was like the swatch card, but I thought I could just swatch on a piece of scrap watercolor paper. So I decided to keep this and I just love it. It's too pretty to throw away. The rest of this sort of packaging is going to meet the same fate, and just a really nice touch. And this is the new watercolor set. It's a bit more muted in the shades. There's a lot of greens. And I really wanted to see if I could try Mermaid next year, which is a little art challenge. I've got her other two here as well, the brights and the neutrals. And if you've seen any of my other videos that I've got up, I use them to death, that and the Mermaid markers. I couldn't get all of the new Mermaid markers, and I thought I'll just sort of invest in these 4, which is the Shimmering Sky, and then I can sort of gradually build up my collection maybe. They've all got like a shimmery glimmer to them, and yeah, I'm really, really excited for those. Okay, last but not least from this box, because I've got other stuff to show you, is the collage papers. Oh, it's so beautiful. You get so many. So it says 30 there. Even on one sheet, it's got heaps of designs. So you remove the backing paper and apply with the matte medium, which is this one here. I've never tried it before. I think I'm going to have a lot of fun using that, so that's cool. So this arrived today as well. This is Jane's Beautiful Faces book. And it's a really great guide to sort of emulating the iconic faces that she makes. And she goes through step by step with the eyes, the nose, the lips, even the eyebrows and the hairline, which is really, really sort of important. There's some beautiful, inspiring designs in here too. So if you're ever stuck for any sort of ideas, you can kind of use this as a bit of a springboard. I'm really looking forward to diving into this. I kind of have my own style, maybe. I don't know if that's... I don't know. The stuff that I do is faces as well, but it's a lot more structured, I want to say. But Jane's is a little bit more whimsical and free, so I kind of want to be a little bit more loose in the design. So I think this could be a very good start to experiment with that. And these are some other Jane items that I managed to grab. I was so excited to see that my local art store is now stocking Jane Davenport stuff. I've wanted these for a really long time. These are the acrylic paints. So I'm probably a little bit late to the party. I know that these have been around for maybe 12 months, maybe even more. But I have wanted these for so long because they have a matte finish. So if you want to use ink or colored pencils over the top, it's going to sort of be able to incorporate that. Next are the washi tapes. So I've already got these washi tapes as before, which are individual strips in different designs. These ones are really cool because it's got different facial features. You can construct your own face. And this one is the plain journal tape, all different widths, just like this one, but only three of them have designs on them. I saw a really great video from Ali Brown recently. I'll link it down below in the description box. But she was using this one, colored them in individually, and then fussy cut around them. So she sort of had her own little collection of stickers to use in her journals. These other four, you can actually go ahead and use your own mediums like paints and inks and watercolors, and sort of make your own washi tape. So I couldn't pass that up. And last but not least is the first edition collage papers. The second collection collage papers comes in these plastic bags, whereas this one's in the cardboard box. I'll have to say that too, that's amazing. I love how bright and fluid and flowy everything is. So I have a lot here to keep me busy for a long time. I might jump into this glitzy palette, the new one with all the greens, and I might actually do some swatches. I've got my Jane Davenport plain canvas journal. I still haven't painted the front of it yet. But yeah, I'm leaving the cover as a reward. So when I finally fill this up, which I kind of have a long way to go, I'll be able to paint over that and yeah, treat myself. So I'm just going to choose the page. That was my last painting that I did, and that's the neutrals color, this one. Why am I struggling with packaging so much today? Oh, I have a sparkle. I don't know where the sparkle came from. That's a little bit of magic that came with my watercolors. I'm actually excited to see the swatch card because there's always been a bit of artwork. Yes. Oh, that's so cool. I'm definitely keeping that. Oh, I love it. So what I might do is I'll go ahead and unwrap all of these individual watercolors and I'll be right back. Okay, so I just sprayed this palette with a spray bottle just to activate everything. And I'm going to start trying out some of these new shades. Alright, for some reason, and I'm not sure why, but my camera decided to cut out the last three shades that I was painting here. Like, the camera was still on, but it just stopped recording, so I apologize for that. But basically, this is Sea Mist, Flirtatious, and Alchemy. So these two are metallic shades. They're not overwhelmingly metallic, which is a nice change. They're quite subtle. You can see that it catches the light quite nicely. So I've pretty much just realized that my audio on my external microphone hasn't been recording until now, and I can't redo what I just did. So these are the four. I think it's got a little ball bearing in there. If you shake it side to side, you're going to mix it all together. But I actually have to go ahead now and remove these so that the ink can flow all the way to the brush tip. Yep, I had to start with the one that's the most difficult for me to pronounce, the Aurora Australis. So I've already done two fails in this video. Let's go for a third and see if this goes everywhere. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh my God, I knew it was going to be sparkly, but this is crazy sparkly. I hope that my lights are picking up on that. I love it, it's beautiful. This is Milky Way. The brush is a little stiff, of course, because the ink hasn't penetrated all the bristles yet, but that's fine. It's a beautiful navy blue. Polar lights. These remind me of the sparkly shoes out of Wizard of Oz. And this is, oh my god, Planet something or other. I don't even want to attempt to say that. This is very Barbie. So there's a lot of variety going on with these different products. So I can create a whole bunch of different looks. Okay, well, I think I might end it here because it might be going for too long. Thank you so much, and I hope that you enjoyed it, especially the fails. But that's okay, that's life. Sometimes that happens and we just have to roll with it. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them down below and I'll happily get back to you. I'd really appreciate if you gave this video a thumbs up and even subscribe to this channel if you feel so inclined. And be sure to check out my other videos where I've actually used some Jane Davenport supplies to paint some portraits and do some art journaling, stuff like that. Thank you so much.